Hello and welcome back. This is Chris with Marksman Shooting Sports in Westfield, Indiana, and you are watching Marksman TV. Today's video is a tabletop comparison and review of the brand new Smith & Wesson Shield 2.0 380 EZ, and I will be comparing that with the Smith & Wesson Shield 2.0 9mm. So we're going to do an unboxing and then move through a point-by-point comparison of the two. If you've been here before, you know the drill. Stick around, it's coming up now. All right, let's go ahead and get into the unboxing. I'm gonna do this side by side. So they both come in the exact same box. Starting over here with the 9mm, open it up. We have the handgun inside this blue sleeve. Go ahead and clear that loaded chamber indicator flag out of there and check that we're clear. Now it does come with one 8-round magazine inserted in the handgun. And then we have a 7-round flat floor plated magazine included as well. Then you have your warranty and instruction information, your gun safety lock as well, and that's it. Now moving over to the 380, again, the exact same box. We have in here the little blue sleeve with the firearm inserted. Go ahead and clear that out of there. And inserted, we do have one flush mounted 8-round magazine. And then over here as well, we do have another 8-round flush mounted magazine, just like the other one. Safety lock instructions, warranty information, all of that. All right, let's go ahead and jump into the specs. I have the Shield 2.0 9mm here and the Shield 2.0 EZ 380 over here. So starting off with the 9mm, it does have a weight of 20.8 ounces. It is 4.4 inches tall with that flush magazine inserted. And with the extended magazine inserted, it is 4.9 inches tall. It has an overall length of 6.1 inches, and it does have a barrel length of 3.1 inches. Jumping over here to the 380. Now the barrel length on this is 3.7 inches, so we are at about 0.6 inches longer than on the 9mm. That makes the overall length at 6.7 inches. Now it is a little bit lighter at 18.5 ounces, so you are about 2.3 ounces lighter on the 380. And it is a height of 4.9 inches tall. That basically means the height is exactly the same as the 9mm when it has its extended magazine inserted, but you do get the advantage in the 9mm of getting it just a little bit shorter when you put in that flush mag, which you do not get on the 380. So going ahead and showing you how that kind of stacks up here on the table. So you see the height, I'm gonna turn this a little bit towards you, is roughly the same. Now if I flip the two over, you will see that the 9mm fits within the footprint perfectly of the 380, except the 380 extends right out here on the front. So that's the difference. Of course, if you were to take this mag out and put in the flush magazine, you would see how much further the 380 extends behind it. Now let's go ahead and talk about the slides, starting here with the 9mm. Now this is a machined stainless steel slide, and it does have Smith & Wesson's Armonite finish, which is their version of melanite, or their term for melanite treatment. Okay, here in the rear, you are gonna notice fish scale serrations. You have your external extractor here, and then you have fish scale serrations up here at the front. Now this is a little bit different. This is one of the changes from the original Shield. I do have a video on that showing the difference between the original Shield and the 2.0. So you could go watch that and then compare the original Shield to the 380. Say for example, you have the original Shield, not the 2.0, you're thinking of the new 2.0 380. Go watch that video as a reference, then you can kind of see the differences and apply those to the 380. Anyway, moving right along, right up here at the top, you do have a loaded chamber indicator in the form of a port opening on the top of the chamber. So when you do have a round inserted, you will see that brass kind of shining back at you. Keep in mind, you will need daylight to see that, or any type of light. If you're in the dark, you won't be able to see that brass. Up here at the front, you do have a dovetailed front sight and a dovetailed rear sight. So they are windage adjustable. They are not elevation adjustable. They are metal in construction and they are in a 3-dot configuration. Now, as you can see in the back, this is a striker fire pistol, which I will talk a little bit more about when we get after disassembly, but keep that in mind for now. Moving on to this side, again, you will see the rear slide serrations. This model has a safety. You can get this without the safety. The safety is only in the form of this little lever right here, okay? Going along, you do have your Smith & Wesson graphics, M&P Shield 2.0 right here, M2.0, so that way you know. You have your front slide serrations just like on the other side. bringing in the M&P 2.0 380 Shield EZ. Now, real quick to start off, EZ stands for, it's basically the abbreviation of easy. So it's easy to rack, easy trigger, easy to load, that sort of thing. So we'll go through all those points as I move through it. So this is a stainless steel machine slide, just like the other Shield, and it does have the Smith & Wesson Armo-Knite finish on it. Now, starting here in the back, you do have the fish-scaled slide serrations as well. Now, interestingly enough, there is a bevel right here, and the fish scale, let's let this focus, right here, your rearmost fish scale serration right here is actually protruding off the edge of the slide. What that does is that gives you two contact points for easy racking of the slide, so you can grab it right here in these notches. You have the same thing on the other side, so you can grab it right here in these notches, or you can grab it from the rear in these notches. That's sort of like the little racking wings you see on the back of the VP9. So it's actually really nice and a lot more positive to get to rack the slide. And the slide itself is a lot easier to rack than on the 9mm, which can be a little bit heavier. Anyway, moving right along, right up here at the front, there are front fish-scaled slide serrations as well. Now moving up to the top, there is a loaded chamber indicator just like we saw on the original Shield. Now this one is more tactile, so this little ramp will raise when there is a round in the chamber. So this gives you the advantage of seeing that ramp raise during the day. You can also feel it at night, like we couldn't do on the 9mm, so a little bit better improvement there. Now the rear sights are dovetailed and they are metal in construction. They can be drift adjustable for windage, but not elevation. Up at the front, you do have a fixed front sight post, and these are also in a three-dot configuration. Now, while you're looking at the back, this actually is a hammer-fired gun, not striker, so I will explain that a little bit more after disassembly. Moving on, this is also the safety version. You can get this firearm without the safety, where it's just, this is deleted. Now, unlike the 9mm Shield, these safety wings are a little bit larger, and they are ambidextrous, they are on both sides. So it's gonna be a little bit more difficult to carry with this. You do have another safety feature here, which we'll talk more about when we talk about the frame. This could be carried, but due to the size increase and that sort of thing, and kind of the large size of these, kind of the safety lever here, this reminds me more of like the full size or the double stack compact M&P line. Kind of fits more in that niche, but anyway, you have your slide serrations on both sides that work the exact same way on front and back. Okay, let's go ahead and take a look at the triggers here, starting with the Shield 2.0 9mm. So first of all, the trigger is polymer in construction, and you will see kind of a little break or a hinge point here. So when I pull at the base of the trigger, you'll see a little notch under there that's moving out of the way. So when I pull that at the base, it moves that little notch out of the way, then I can pull the trigger through. If I don't, like if I pull up here, that little notch stays down and it engages with the rear of the frame, not allowing me to pull through. So that's your trigger safety. You have to pull on the trigger to engage the firearm. So keep that in mind as a safety feature. Now, showing you the trigger pull, I'm gonna go ahead and start to pull. There's a little bit of take up right here. Once you get past that take up, you'll hit that wall. Go ahead and pull through. Right there is your nice clean break at about 6 to 6.5 pounds. I'll go ahead and show you the reset. So I'm gonna start to release. Right here, that's the reset. You heard a little bit audible click there. Go ahead and pull through again. Again, 6.5 to 7 pounds. I think I said six to seven pounds, anywhere in there. But anyway, I'll show you that one more time. Reset. Now also keep in mind, you do have an over travel stop right here at the back. Now, referring back to the original Shield versus the 2.0 video that I did, there was an improvement in the 2.0. It is a slight improvement. It's not as gritty as the original Shield, if that's what you have. So consider that as well. Okay, so taking a look at the trigger on the 380, there's a couple differences right off the bat. So the trigger itself is polymer, just like on the 9mm. There is no little hinge point there, so there is no trigger safety. Now keep in mind, you do have a grip safety here in the back. So without that being engaged and I pull through, obviously nothing happens. Trigger's not locked up, it'll just travel its entire movement and, you know, not break. So with going ahead and applying pressure on the back of this grip safety, I'll go ahead and show you the trigger pull. So we take a little bit of take up there and you see how it almost touches the back of the over travel stop. After that take up, we'll go ahead and give it a nice little squeeze and it breaks. And that's actually only about 5 pounds of pressure. So pretty significantly lighter than the 9mm. Now, I couldn't really notice a difference between the original Shield and the 2.0, but I can definitely feel a difference between this and the 2.0. This is definitely a lot lighter, a lot crisper, not as spongy, not as gritty. It's just a better trigger. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and reset this and show you the reset on here. So I'm gonna go ahead and kind of position my finger back here. Release. And right there's a reset. Actually a lot shorter than on the 9. Go ahead and pull again to a break. Nice and clean. So I really like this trigger a lot actually. Okay, let's get into disassembly. This is the 9mm. I'm gonna go ahead and clear the magazine and check that I'm clear, and I am. So with the slide held open to the rear, there is a takedown lever on this side. I'm going to actually go ahead and throw down into the 6 o'clock position. Now I can gently release pressure off this slide and let it come to rest with the frame, and then give it a nice squeeze on the trigger and then release the two halves. Now under here on the slide, I will go ahead and remove the double guide rod and spring. And then there is the barrel, and that is field stripped. Now on the 380, the process is gonna be very much the same. I'll go ahead and remove the magazine and check that I'm clear, and I am. Go ahead and hold the slide open to the rear. And there is also a takedown lever over here, which I'll throw down into the 6 o'clock. Now this is a lot easier to use than on the 9mm, just very little effort. Go ahead and release and let it come forward. Now keep in mind, there's nothing holding the slide on once you do that, so it will just slide right off. Now under here, you do have a single guide rod and spring, and then there is your barrel. Now the guide rod itself is polymer in construction, looks really, I mean, I'm sure it's fine, but it's not the most sturdy looking thing as compared to the guide rod over here on the 9mm. So you have obviously a lot more spring tension here. It's a 9mm, but these are stainless steel components, just a lot more rugged and durable than this. I would probably upgrade this. Personally, this is actually pretty cheap looking. Okay, let's jump into the frames. Now, there are gonna be quite a bit of differences here. Here's a 9mm. So the texturing on this is very coarse, it's very rough. And this is one of the complaints that people have had on the 2.0, is that when you are carrying this, especially inside the waistband, if you're not wearing some sort of undershirt between the gun and your skin, this could really start chafing on you, especially, you know, during a hot day or something when you're sweating. But just, it's like rubbing sandpaper against your waist all day. And I think this was a really poor oversight. They should have gone with something less aggressive. But you can always get some sort of wraparound if you want to remedy that problem. Anyway, moving along. Now, the magazine release does have a metal core in it. It is polymer in construction, and it is not reversible. So if you are a right-handed shooter, that's not a big deal. Left-handed shooters, you will have to get used to the magazine release being really set up for a right-handed shooter, which is kind of a bummer because there are plenty of left-handed people. I'm actually left-handed myself, but I do shoot right-handed. Now, you do have the takedown lever here, which we've already talked about. Your slide stop is here, and it is not ambidextrous. And then you do have a safety on this model. This is a very low profile safety. If I'm going to carry, I'd rather have this safety than what we saw on the 380 version, which I'll talk a little bit more about in a minute. And again, this is not ambidextrous, so keep that in mind if you are left-handed. We already talked about the trigger. You do have an over travel stop right back here. There is no rail space if you wanted to mount a lighter laser to it. Now, you can get the 2.0s with a laser option, which I actually have here at my store. So that's an option there for you. It does mount around the trigger guard, so you know you can do that. Coming up here into the top. Now, as I mentioned, this is a striker fire pistol. You do have steel guide rails for your slide. All your other components, guide rails back here as well, all your other important components are steel in construction. So it really has everything you need. It's a really good handgun. Overall construction, of course, on this is polymer. Save for the aggressive texturing here, it's great. It's just like the original Shield. Okay, bringing in the 380, first of all, grip texturing. It is more aggressive than on the original Shield, but it is not nearly as aggressive as on the 9mm Shield 2.0 or any of the rest of the 2.0 family. So you do notice good texturing, but this isn't so much to where I'd be like, man, that would really suck to have that rubbing up against my against my side all day. So really, I think it's appropriate. It's better. It's kind of grained down a little bit, which I appreciate. Now back here, of course, can't get away without noticing that grip safety. It does require, I don't know exactly how much weight, but it's not like a 1911. It's actually kind of the pivoted point is down here at the bottom. So you do have this kind of high arc here in the back, which does feel kind of weird in the back. I don't know, it's something I would have to get used to. When I was actually even playing with the trigger, it took me some, like at some points I didn't quite have it engaged all the way. In a stressful situation, that could potentially be an issue unless you practice a lot with this and you get really used to how that feels and the appropriate amount of pressure you need to put on that. again, it's not like a 1911. A 1911, you can barely grip the grip frame and you're already like engaging that grip safety. So I'm not too sure about that. I don't know why there was a need for this on this firearm, but it's there. Maybe some people would like it. Now, along with that, you do have the safety over here. It is kind of that large paddle style. So keep that in mind if you want to carry. Sorry about that, just got a phone call, but this is actually, I have one here without the safety, so you can kind of see what that looks like there. Moving along, we mentioned that the kind of the frame is extended a little bit beyond the original 9mm version. Now with that, you do get the benefit of a rail if you wanted to add stuff, so that's cool. If you need it, it's there. No big deal. You do have the over travel stop here behind the trigger. Now moving up into the top, there's some differences here. So of course the guide rails here are steel in construction, all your internal components steel in construction. Now you will notice here this is actually a hammer. So the 380 variant is actually hammer fired. It's an internal hammer. It is not striker fired. If I bring in the slide, once it focuses, you'll see back here there is the back of the firing pin, and there's all this clearance space back here for that hammer to, of course, fall and hit and strike the back of that there. One other point to note with that ambidextrous safety selector, there is actually the magazine release is reversible. So this is a lot more friendly for left-handed shooters. If you're left-handed, feel fine to pick it up and go ahead and switch that safety, or I'm sorry, the magazine release over, and you have that. Now, your slide stop is not ambidextrous, so you will have to, of course, either rack it from the rear or switch hands to release the slide, but that's really no big deal. And you usually see that on a lot of ambidextrous guns anyway. Finishing up with the barrels, we have the 380 on top, the 9mm here on the bottom. Now these are both stainless steel and machined, and they do have the Armonite finish just like these slides. Now they are basically, they are the same in terms of overall fit and finish. Of course the 9mm is bored out for a larger caliber, that goes without saying. On the back they both have polished feed ramps. Just very nice barrels, not really a whole lot to say about them. Okay, some final takeaways here. First of all, price point. Both of these are selling right now in about the $350 to $400 price point. You're typically going to be on the higher end of that, most likely on the 380 since it is very new to the market. So you don't have a lot of dealer programs or anything going on these right now. The same is not necessarily true on the 2.09 millimeters, the Shields. We're kind of seeing the prices on them come down a little bit. Around the first of the year, some dealer programs kicked off with these things. So our price points are coming down. So at least for the time being, $350, $400, probably $400 on the 380. For that value, I think it's a good option. What I see this mainly competing with is, I don't know if you all remember the PK380 by Walther or Smith & Wesson, whoever you wanna, whichever way you wanna look at it. The PK380 was always one of those weird animals, and it tended to have an audience mainly geared towards women, and that's kinda where I see this as well. This is sort of a good hybrid between a concealed carry versus a range gun versus kind of a home defense. They went a little bit larger on it. It's kind of weird to go to a larger overall size than the 9mm, but dropping the caliber down to a 380. The PK380, I used to stock them here in my store. They had a lot of issues, so I quit carrying them, but while I had them, they were very popular with women. The slides are very easy to rack, much like this. Trigger pull was very nice on them. Being a 380, did have a little bit less recoil, although I think in smaller frame 380s, they tend to be kind of snappy. But anyway, that's kind of the niche I see. So this is the sort of thing, and with reservations of sounding sexist or anything, just from my observation as a gun store owner, the number one thing when women come in, the number one thing they ask for is, hey, I have a hard time racking the slides on firearms or pulling the trigger, especially double action, like a double action only revolver or anything like that. I need something that's really easy to rack the slide on. So they always looked at the PK380s, the Burst of Thunders, and the SIG 938s and 238s. That's just the way it is. That's been my experience. This is now an option where you have something that's very easy to use, which is, again, where they get the name easy. So there's that, and I think it'll fit into that niche well. It could get more people shooting. Hopefully this is not going to have the same problems that the PK380 had. I see this as sort of an update of that firearm. Now, overall, the slide manipulation, great. The sights, I like. Just the feel, I mean, just the ease in which you can operate this, it is absolutely comfortable. Really nice thin profile. The magazines hold 8 rounds. Even the magazines have these little tabs on them here so you can assist and pull down the follower so it's easier to load. PK380, I believe, is the exact same way. Trigger pull, really nice and clean. The one thing I don't like, and I don't know why they did this, is the grip safety. It's very heavy. The hinge point is down here at the bottom as opposed to the top. So like on an XDS or a 1911, typically the hinge point is up here at the top. So the flare out is at the bottom. So that's where the meat of your hand is sitting to aid in pushing in that grip safety. This flares out at the top. So that's engaging with the web of your hand. So this is where you have to push. So you really have to squeeze into it to really disengage that safety. Which, I don't know, I think that that kind of defeats a lot of the purpose of it being easy to use. I think allowing the user to purchase an option with the manual safety, if that's what they want, I think that that is fine. A trigger safety, if that's the way, you know, if you wanted to keep it safe outside of having a manual safety, I guess that's fine. But the whole grip safety thing, I'm just asking why. Why did you do that? So, hey, if anybody from Smith & Wesson or anybody who knows the answer to that, please leave that down in the comment section. Just seems to defeat a lot of the purpose of kind of the usability of this firearm. Well, guys, that is all the time I have for you today on these. Thank you so much for stopping by. If you enjoyed that, please let me know by hitting that like button. If you have any questions, leave those down for me in the comment section. I will try to answer as many of those as I can. And if you want to see more content like this, please hit that subscribe button. Again, this is Chris with Marksman Shooting Sports in Westfield, Indiana. You are watching Marksman TV. I will see you next time.